My name is Pascal Lepeu, and I'm the curator of the Cartier Collection. The Cartier Collection owns today 1,600 pieces, including jewelry, of course, but also watches, clocks, and items. We are in charge of a very important part of our history. My principal mission is to maintain this collection in perfect condition. We work a lot with museums all around the world because it is very nice to have this collection, but it is also very important for us to share it with the more people possible in the world. The history of Cartier starts with Louis-François Cartier in 1847. Then Louis-François Cartier had one son, Alfred Cartier, and Alfred had three sons, Louis, Pierre, and Jacques. Alfred Cartier had already an idea of expanding the business outside of France, and he will do it with his three sons. Louis Cartier was in charge of the Paris branch. Pierre Cartier opened the London branch in 1902 and then moved to Cartier, New York, where he opened the Fifth Avenue boutique in 1909. Jacques, the youngest brother, took over the London branch in 1909. All of them were very capable and they did all very well with their own branch. They had different specialties. Louis was the esthete, Pierre was the entrepreneur, and Jacques became a very good specialist of stones, and he also had lots of friendship and very good relations with India and the Maharajas, all the princes that came to visit London. Cartier developed the Cartier style. When we create something, we create a Cartier jewel or a Cartier watch or a Cartier object. And today, it's the same process with the creation. We have designers. They still work with the library of Louis Cartier, the library that Louis Cartier created the early 20th century. Princess Mathilde, during all her life, purchased more than 200 Cartier jewels. We keep in our archives her account with all these jewels. On the English side, I would say that a very important client was the Prince of Wales. We used aquamarines a lot in England, and in America, I could name the Vanderbilt. They crossed the ocean twice per year to buy new clothes and new dresses and of course new jewels. The Panther appeared for the first time at Cartier in 1914 on a wristwatch reproducing the Panther coat using black onyx and diamonds. Then we saw the Panther on a vanity case. The shape of the Panther was set with diamonds on a vanity case, which is a box in which you have powder compartments and a mirror. But that was very popular in the 20s. The first time the Panther appeared in its three dimensions was in 1948, and that was for the Duchess of Windsor. It's not the one we have in the Cartier collection, it's another one in gold, and the Panther stands on a big emerald. And today it can look normal to wear a Panther jewel, but at that time it was very different. And the Panther was the expression of the personality of the Duchess of Windsor. And she was like the Panther. She was very thin, very elegant, not particularly kind, and she was where she wanted to be, on top of the world. And when you look at the Panther we have in the Cartier collection that belonged to the Duchess of Windsor, you have a beautiful and very delicate diamond set Panther on a huge round blue sapphire, which could be compared to the earth. Later, we will do the same with Maria Felix, creating a crocodile or snake necklace. And not every woman at that time could wear such a jewel. You needed a strong personality. My favorite jewel at Cartier, it's very difficult to say. I love particularly a tiara, which is now in the Cartier collection. It's set with onyx and diamonds. It's like an Art Deco design, but very early in our creation. Another jewel would be the Tutti Frutti. We still create Tutti Frutti today because Tutti Frutti are a real creation by Cartier. They were inspired by India, but you don't find this type of jewelry in India. And at the time, you didn't find similar style of jewel anywhere in the world. One curator of an exhibition we had in the past called them exotic fantasies. And it's really a creation. It was something completely new, and this is probably why we still today create Tutti Frutti, and it's why they're today so popular. It's a great job being the curator of the Cartier collection. It's an honor. I enjoyed it since 25 years now, and I'm looking forward to doing it for many years to come.